But, you know, the reason why we're here today is to, you know, inspire. That's something that I love to do. I love to inspire. And I'm looking right into the camera right now. And I'm telling you to get up off your butts. Focus on your dreams, goals, and ambitions. Every journey is your journey. You can't duplicate someone else's success. Your destiny is your destiny. You have to grab it. You have to first understand that. If you don't have that knowledge, go read a book, take a class, get that knowledge. Wisdom is an amazing thing, you know, and don't forget prayer. Let me explain to you how I pray. Thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you've given me. Thank you for the clarity in which I wake up every day with. I appreciate everything that you've ever done for me. I know that you have blessed me since before I was even born. But on this day, on this day, in this moment, please give me the clarity and the wisdom to know that when one of your blessings are passing in front of me, I can reach out and actually grab it today with all my might and do what you want me to do with it. Turn it into something productive and positive and make a difference in this world. Amen. That's how I pray.
I am Stacey A. Cross, and there is no E in my name.
An original idea that I had, but he didn't know I had the idea. Putting everything on the left side. So we went up into the apartment, because as of right now, the only way to get to the apartment is entering through the building next door, walking up the steps, and walking to in between the two buildings.
Okay.
To get to my apartment up here, right? Because at one point, the guy next door owned all three properties. That's just how it's always been. So basically, upstairs is the closet with the washer dryer. Next to it is a oversized bathroom. We're gonna shift everything in the bathroom down. Take the washer and dryer that's on the opposite side of the wall, move it down into the bathroom, take the steps, run them straight up into the living room. Done. Save so much money and time. Now, we also have a problem with the being ADA compliant, because there's a step right here. So
stepping
originally
up.
We had the ATM machine right here.
Okay.
And
yep.
Then we had the step right here. Right? So we were gonna have to bust out this step, put a ramp, make it ADA compliant. So over here, basically what we're gonna do is right here we were focused on putting the entryway for the apartment here, running up those steps, shifting left, and the doorway to the pet-friendly dog bakery. So now what we've done, again, my GC, Mike, came up with the idea of, we were gonna lay this up here, brick this up, and just put a big window here. So now we're gonna shift and make that the window. Build this up, make that the window, and then put the door here.
Yep.
The reason why we're gonna do that is because we already have a ramp built in a place that is ADA compliant. So all we gotta do is put a door here and a door here, run the steps straight up, done deal.
Follow your dreams, follow your goals, follow your ambitions, and don't be afraid to, you know, learn from people that may be a little smarter than you or a little more creative than you. If you think you're the smartest person in the room, you're a dummy. You learn from these people, you know? That's the only way you're gonna get ahead, is that you get up off your attitude, get up off your laziness, try to focus on your dreams, goals, and ambitions, and learn from everybody that you can. Read a book, take a class. Your dream, goal, and ambition is only yours. Your journey is yours. Can't nobody do it for you. You cannot duplicate anybody else's success. You gotta figure it out for yourself. Start small, grow big.
Thing and you're doing it the right way, you didn't get the right results, go back to doing the right thing the right way until you get the right results. It's just a circle until
yep.
you actually find that success. That's basically it. So come on in, let me show you the conference room.
Lenny, love this one right here.
That Pops. Right there is a good friend of mine, Sandy.
Yeah, this thing pops.
Love it. This particular piece right here, Sandy did an exhibition in my gallery, and so I had to go to her studio to pick out some paintings. As soon as I walked in, I saw this piece. I said, that's my piece.
That's yours.
I wrote her a check right there because I had to have it.
This is an awesome,
piece, right?
Yeah. And I remember you wondering what you were going to put on that wall for a while.
This is it. I love this piece so much.
You've seen how I was attracted to it immediately.
So if you look, this gallery, the aesthetic is Tudor style. So the early inhabitants were English and Dutch, you know, settlers, and they're famous in their culture for Tudor style buildings. So this particular building is the true color combination that you'll find in England. And the reason why I know that is because my wife and I took my mother and our two daughters to France, right, for a week. And then we caught the channel over to England, right, because I needed to go look at the aesthetics and the architecture so I can bring back the proper color combination for this art gallery. This art gallery is amazing. I designed this based on the five elements of feng shui too, so the energy level in here, when you walk in, you're like, wow.
Yeah.
And the overall aesthetic, I mean, I built it from scratch, you know what I'm saying? Inside, I gutted the entire building, and I started from scratch. Now, if you look at the colors, you look at the four corners up here, they're the rectangles, the red, right, to pull in that beautiful red color. Now that color red is actually called colonial red, right? Now I designed every aspect of the inside, but I also did the outside equally beautiful because the tile that's here is meant to look like it's been here for many, many years, but it's actually new tile. I did this building over in 2012. We opened up October 5th, 2013. So when you walk in, it just opens up to this amazing, beautiful space.
Wow.
So I am the very first one that brought a living wall to Manayunk. This is a real living wall. The light shining on the wall is New York style Broadway lighting that mimics natural daylight to help the plant life go through the cycle of photosynthesis, creating clean oxygen. Now, I also have an air purification system on the HVAC system, along with the plant life creating clean oxygen. The air quality in this building is exceptional, adding to the beautiful energy and the feng shui design element. So if you walk back here, you'll see that I implemented beautiful turquoise and marble, rare marble finishes. Okay. Because this is one of my favorite colors, a turquoise color, one of my favorite colors. And, you know, we have to have the wine.
Got to have the wine.
Got to have the nice wine.
Absolutely.
So if you look above the door, you'll see a beautiful stained glass finish. And there's a saying up on that wall. Here at the Bazemore Gallery, we believe that when buying from an artist, you are buying more than just a painting. You are buying more than just an item, okay? You are buying hundreds of hours of failures and experimentation. You are buying days, weeks, months of frustration and moments of pure joy. You are not just buying a thing. You are buying a piece of art, part of a soul, a moment of someone's life. Most importantly, you're buying the artist more time to do something they are passionate about.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Now to your left, if you look at this wood relief sculpture, this was done by Jordan Ivanov in May of 75. Now, when I bought this building and decided to put an art gallery in here, I thought it was serendipitous that I found this in the basement in 12 pieces. And again, it's of the Manayunk Canal done by Jordan Ivanov, May of 1975. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
This is Debbie, our sales manager here at the Bazemore Gallery.
How you doing, Debbie? Real quick. How you doing, Debbie?
Can you tell them quickly about the, you know, current exhibition?
Oh, the current exhibition is Brooklyn Years. She's from Philadelphia. She works in brick dust, which she's foraged from bricks she finds on abandoned lots and abandoned buildings in Fishtown, and she drags them back to her studio, shatters them, crushes them with a mortar and pestle, mixes them with a medium, and paints with it.
Wow.
She also uses the raw material you can see in these paintings over here. She'll sprinkle it on and incorporate it so you get texture to it.
I like being in a state of staying busy, but every time I go to relax and chill, right? Because I've been successful and, you know, I want to try to enjoy some of the fruits of my labor. There's projects going on at the same time, but I've learned how to juggle them. Putting really good people in place, right, to make it easier for you. And as long as you got that phone, the email, the text, the phone calls, it makes it so much better, especially if you're working with a team that understands your drive, understands your essence. Then it's pretty, you can do multiple things, and juggling ain't nothing but a clown act. Right. You know, it's just, you know what I mean? So, being a real estate investor, you have to know what you're doing. You can't just, you know, spend money and make money and lose money.
You can't just spend, make, and lose.
You can't spend money, lose money, waste money, don't work. Got to know what you're doing.
Got to know what you're doing, guys.
And I've been a licensed realtor for 15 years now, and I used to service clients in Center City and on the main line, and kind of got sick of it. You know what I mean? I made a lot of people a lot of money, and one day I, you know, had a resolve, and you know, I said, you know what? Let me just do this myself. You know, I'll make some money for me.
Yes.
And about 2.5 years ago, I invested in these two corner properties right here.
And I used to live in it.
Yeah, you used to, yeah.
You used to live in that building, yeah. Right?
So 4343 and 4345 Main Street are solid investment. When I bought these 2.5 years ago, I bought them for $1.2 million. And 2.5 years later, after painting them and filling the space with leasing out the space to tenants, I just sold them about 2 months ago for $2.1 million. Nice. So all of that profit is essentially being reinvested back here into Main Street Manayunk. So let's walk up and so this building right here. This is another building that I own.
Now this is the first of the kind where you actually drop it. You demoed this, the entire building, right?
I demoed this, and it's the first time in over 50 years historical has allowed anyone to demo a commercial building on the main street here. So what you're about to see is, I mean, it's unbelievable.
Yeah.
It's history in the making.
Yep.
Right?
What? Oh, man.
Oh. So, what you see here is a blank canvas.
Yes.
Blunt. I can pretty much do whatever I want. And, you know, since I bought the property, my God, it's been 2 years, I think, a year and a half. I bought the property a year ago. Yeah, about a year ago. We've dug in it. We've got it to this point. And
yeah.
It was, you know, it was very difficult to get the city to, you know, understand that this building has been dilapidated for over 25 years and was on the verge of caving in and hurting somebody. So we had to have an engineer come in and label it
Imminently
dangerous.
right? So once that is, once this building is tagged imminently dangerous, then now the city, because of some issues in the past, don't want anybody to get hurt or killed. So now they gotta, you know, work with this.
Yeah.
So they did. The city of Philadelphia was gracious in working with us. You know, I'm a developer, so you always want to have a good relationship with the city of Philadelphia or whatever city you're working in. So they were gracious in working with us to make sure this is safe. So we demoed by hand, right? No machinery. It took about 40 days. Nobody even knew we were here.
Yeah.
It was quiet, it was quick, and now it's safe. And now I get to build whatever I want.
And as an artist, you love blank canvases, huh?
I love blank canvases. Yep. Now here's the deal. What I'm gonna do here, I've already changed the whole landscape of Main Street Manayunk. You know what I mean? I've done, every building I've ever touched is outstandingly designed and done over. It's I'd like to put my hand on it and make it, you know, into my own, the essence of who I am. So if you look over here, the Bazemore Gallery, we'll walk over there real quick. But before we go there, this is my juice bar called the Juice Merchant.
The aesthetics of this building, sick.
So, what you see is my design. And the beauty of this is, you know, I was working at the art gallery every day. I basically couldn't come out of the gallery and find a bottle of water. You know what I mean? So it was very difficult to find healthy alternatives. So I said, you know what? I just bought this building. And originally I was just going to lease it out to somebody, but people kept bringing me their same old ideas, you know, a new cheesesteak place, a new wings place. I'm like, we need something healthy on the street. So then I was like, all right, instead of renting it out, I'll design and build out my own organic juice bar. So in designing this, I implemented the five elements of feng shui, using beautiful energy and synergies between the materials in the space itself, and the energy of people that are naturally doing something good for themselves, right? So when you come here to order one of our juices, smoothies, or one of our food dishes, you're essentially, because of the quality of our product and it being organic, you're essentially doing something amazing and positive for yourself. So that creates positive energy. So as soon as you walk through the door, you'll notice underneath the countertop is a space where your energy naturally flows into the space where the employees are working. You give your order and they make whatever you want with love and positivity and pass it back over to you on top of the counter, over the counter.
Mm.
So if you notice, the ceiling line has five pitches. It goes down, up, and the ambient lighting, the LED lighting, gives the space an amazing ambiance. Now, there is an optical illusion I like to call Trump Lloyd. When you first walk in, it looks very intimate here because I made the space seem not so large, right? So essentially, this place doesn't really look as big as it is. Now, I want you to follow me. I'm gonna show you something. See the beautiful natural light reflection off the white tile? You gotta incorporate that into your design to make the space look larger. So I put this big, huge window here to let in this natural light. And if you shift over here, you'll see the beautiful reflection of light off the white tile.
Mm.
But then you'll see how big this place actually is.
Mm.
This place is actually really big.
It's huge.
Relax, I see somebody who's
You're
on
right
the come up, who's on a grind.
Yeah.
And they might not have nothing. They trying to get something. I see them, I'm inspired. Like, oh, I got to get back on it.
Yeah.
You know, because being from Norristown, you know, born and raised in Norristown, you know, I'm actually a high school dropout. Right? And the reason why I'm a high school dropout is not because I was ignorant or stupid and didn't do the classwork. I was actually a high school football star and I had football scholarships across the country. University of Tennessee, USC, Florida State, Miami, Notre Dame, you name it, Georgia, like letters. And if you know me and you know my friends, they'll vouch for me because I had letters and letters and letters. I used to talk to Tony Dorsett, Dan Marino, trying to get me to go to the University of Pittsburgh. I went out there. I loved the stadium. They fed me,
walk me through the locker room. I met Craig Ironhead Hayward, a bunch of other players, walked me through the locker room, gave me a nice seat, put a little tag around my neck, said, whatever you want from the concession stand, just go get it. So I know what that's like. Problem is, this dude in high school, I was in 12th grade, he was in 11th grade. He picked a fight with me because he liked my girlfriend. And he spit on me, right? And he hit me. And he went to hit me again. I ducked and I lit him up. It was a reaction, self-defense reaction. But for whatever reason, and I'm not even gonna go there, but I'm the one that got expelled from school and I got charged. So I was, cops came to my crib, you know what I mean? And they were like, you're in trouble. And so out of that whole thing, I got a year probation, you know? And I was thankful for that. Cause I mean, I could have went away for like 15 years, they were saying. Yeah.
Wow.
And so my mom and dad didn't have any money, you know what I mean? They had no money. So couldn't get me another lawyer. I had a public defender who was laughing with the other attorney, the DA, and I nobody was in the courtroom that I knew. I was by myself. None of my friends or family were there. It was just me. And I thought it was unusual that the two attorneys were laughing. So I went over to my public defender. I said, excuse me, sir, can I speak to you? And he was like, I'll be with you in a minute, like snooty. Like, so I was like, all right. So he told me to wait over there. So I waited over there. I'm 18 years old. You know what I mean? And I'm sitting there. He finally came over. He's like, look, son, you're looking at 15 years in jail. And I said, but he spit on me and he hit me and he went to hit me again. Now this particular dude, I've been over his house. His older brother was actually a friend of mine and played on the same football team. So I know that the whole family are black belts, right? So I didn't want to mess with this dude. Forget about the football scholarships and all that. I didn't want to get my ass kicked, right? So when he went to hit me again, being from North Sound, you learn how to fight. So I just boom, bang, you know, lit him up, right? I didn't understand why I was being in trouble. Like I got in trouble. Like nothing ever happened to him, nothing. So I'm sitting there, I'm like, man, like how did this happen? Why am I here? You know what I mean? And so, you know, he said I was lucky to get probation, and I was lucky. Wow. 'Cause this happens to a lot of young kids, you know, all over the world. And so what I'm saying is the tattoo right here that means resilient is real. I've been in the struggle. More than that, I had at one point in my life, I had to knock on the back of restaurants and beg for food. Now this is something that you guys didn't know, right?
I knew that. I knew that. You told me about that.
You know, I went through a bad divorce, lost my house, got foreclosed on, my car got repossessed, I lost my job. I had nothing. I was knocking on the back of restaurants begging for food. You know what I mean? And my child support was paid because I wasn't trying to go to jail. But at the end of the day, I picked myself up and I was resilient and I did the right thing the right way until I got the right results and I never stopped. I never ever stopped. I kept going. I kept going. I kept going. And I won't stop. Can't stop now, because even though I am where I am, I get a little comfortable. I see somebody who's on the rise. I see somebody who's on the grind and I get inspired to do it all over again. So I wake up, it's like Groundhog Day.
So you always try to remain uncomfortable then?
Yeah, I try to remain uncomfortable, which goes back to comfort killers, right? Because comfort killers is trying to make you uncomfortable to get you out of your way. Don't let an opportunity pass you by. Don't set yourself up for failure by not being in the game. Don't count yourself out because you think you might not get it or somebody else told you you couldn't get it. You decide for yourself at the end of the day after you accomplished it. You look up and thank the Lord. What? Thank you, Lord. And then you say,
I am Stacey A. Cross, and there is no E in my name.